Hello, IIL, Thought Leadership News and friends. This is Ed Hoffman. I'm happy to participate in this Q&A about teamwork and collaboration. Yeah, they can be a big difference. You know, team is anytime, but I would say you have a compelling mission where you need to work with others, where you need to use different capabilities to be successful in your outcome. Collaboration is, to me, in essence, simply of high-performing teams that were committed to working together, to sharing, to communicating, to having appreciation for what we're doing. So to me, they should go together, but oftentimes they don't. I think there are a few things that are important for teamwork and collaboration. One of the things that I would say is, why are we working together? It's very important for an effective leader to prioritize the mission and the goals so that you're gaining 110% commitment from the team. The second thing is nourishing the team. I get the word nourishing actually from my wife when she hears me talk about my experiences at NASA. The most effective teams, projects, organizations, they take care of their people. They're aware of their people. Everyone has a voice. They can be heard. And this is the notion of nourishing. And a lot of this has to do with creating a sense of appreciation and gratitude for the ability to work together. And I would say a third thing is the importance of maintaining a sense of meaning and purpose. There's a story in the book, The Smart Mission, of the NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory VITAL project, the very beginning stages of the COVID pandemic. We needed ventilators in the country. And this was a small team, a young team, that came together to develop ventilators that could be used medically, that could use typical capabilities. It could be put together easily and quickly. And it was a low-cost way of dealing with this issue. And when they first came together, they had not worked together before, most of these people. And now they're being asked to collaborate into team at a distance because now we were already in the virtual environment. So one of the things that their team did, which is a sign of an effective team, is they started by talking together and having a conversation. And even though we're doing it at a distance, we're hearing each other. And they determined that it was a safe place to talk, to communicate, to agree, and to disagree. The second thing that the leader did was she read the purpose of why they're working together. It's to develop ventilators. It's to support the medical community. We need to do it very quickly. It's got to pass the regulatory aspect. She read that opening paragraph, and that's a really great thing. We now know why we're working together, and that's a good place. A safe place to work. We can do it as individuals, which is one of the things I'm hoping people listen will do, be leaders. We can do it as teams working together, or we can set up things as an organization. The first thing to do is I really think we focus on people. If you go into my LinkedIn profile, it starts by saying people. People, people. I said this at NASA, say to my students at Columbia, I say this to organizations that I work with. You have to really focus on the people. And that means how are they coming together? How are they communicating? Taking time to express appreciation together, taking time to talk about how they're going to benefit by learning so that they're going to be a better place after this project. So take care of the people aspect. The second thing for creating the sense of an effective project team collaboration is what's our purpose, what's our mission, and what are we trying to accomplish? It sounds simple, but one of the questions I was having a discussion with a leader, a young woman early in career, she was talking about the need to be successful, wanting to be successful. And I asked her, what's your destination? Probably a good question from a former person from NASA, but what's the destination? What's the journey? Where are you trying to go? And where do you want to be in 5 years? Where do you want to be in 2 years? Where do you want to be in 6 months? So I think for teams nowadays, particularly for project teams, for agile teams, for product teams, the teams want to know, where are we going? Is there clarity from the leader? And so I would start with those two things. Take care of your people, talk together, create a safe environment, respect your people, respect their talents, and then make sure it's clear to everyone what's the mission of the larger organization, of the project, and how we contribute to that. I think one of the things I tell teams, and I told NASA folks, one of the things I was fortunate is when new people were hired at NASA, I would often be able to meet with them early in their career. The first thing I'd say is, how do you feel right now? Well, they're excited, they're happy, it's NASA, their moms, their dads are all, you know, expressing. And I say, you know, hold on to that. When we start working at a place, when we start in a project, we're excited. And there's a reason for that, right? Because it's important. Hold on to that feeling, because you're going to have good days, you're going to have bad days. And you don't want to lose that sense of just the fact that we're working on a good place. Most of the people that I'm talking to now, you're working on cool projects, important projects, projects for customers who really need you. And it's important to hold on to that kind of a feeling. I think a second thing that I remember is, don't assume that other people know what you're contributing to the activity. Early in my career, I was invited to a party at the house of actually the deputy administrator of NASA. Used to have a party at the end of the year for interns and co-ops. And his name was Dr. Hans Mark, very senior guy, tall, like 6'5" with a, you know, Austrian type accent. And he asked me, in front of this large group, when he heard that I was an organizational psychologist studying leadership on projects, he said, "Why do I need you here at NASA?" He said, "I know why I need the aerospace engineers, but why do I need you?" And I said, "Well, anything that goes together with an effective project has to do with effective leadership. How do we design teams? How do we communicate? How do we, you know, work and respect each other?" And Dr. Mark was very quick. He said, "Look, I'm a leader. Can you improve me?" So I said, "Give me an example of a couple of things you do as a leader that helps your team." And we went through this discussion, and we went through different examples. And afterwards, he came up to me, and he took me to his office where he showed the different projects that were being worked, different models, you know, model makeup of the International Space Station, which is still several years in the future. And he said, "I appreciate your answer." He said, "I didn't," he told me that his wife said, I did it wrong. I shouldn't have put me on the spot and said, "Why do I need you?" But that's what he was thinking about. Why do we need a psychologist? This was, Tom, this was in the 80s. And he said, "You answered it really very smart. We do need leadership. We do need to collaborate. We do need to communicate effectively together to be successful in these missions that we're undertaking. So thank you for your time." So I always remembered that wherever you go, people may not know what you're doing, what you're contributing, why it's important. So be able to answer the question of, why do I need you here? Whether it's the small business running a deli, why does a customer want to come into your store, or you're leading a major project? So that's the other thing I think I would say is, why do I need you? And appreciate the people, the customers, the regulatory people, the members of the team, for the fact that we're doing something fun and cool together and challenging. This is Ed Hoffman. I want to thank IIL Thought Leadership News and my friends and colleagues listening to this session. I look forward to seeing you in the future online.